okay, once you've got a little bit of an idea of how to make some plots, you know, where you can just be like, you know, x equals 1 to 5 and y equals, I don't know, 3x, except I suck at typing, then it could be plot xy. Okay, so assume you can make a plot. Woohoo! Okay, so plots we can do. CLC, clear. But what we really want to do now is make them pretty. So as with all things, at some point we get desperate and we actually try to look up help. So I'm going to go and type in help plot, and help plot can't, I wish I could make this bigger, but you're going to see there's all this kind of information, and kind of the basics to get started is in this table you see right here. I wonder if I can copy and paste it. There we go. So then you can see it. It's a little bit bigger. So basically there's this table, and you can control the color here. You can control the marker, I guess you'd call it, for the it's the little, like, the data point, you know, if you want the data point to be a star, or if you want the data point to be a circle, or just a regular point. And then the line that connects the points, do you want to be solid, dotted, dash dot, dashed, or no line at all? Okay, so essentially what you can do is you can combine any of these letters with any of these characters, with any of these thingies, or nothing, to get the plot that you want. Okay, sort of. Okay, so I'm gonna leave that there. So let's say that we wanted to make a dotted black line with data points marked by circles. So a dotted black, so black is K, not B, black line with dotted thingies marked by circles. And that's just an O, like that's just the letter O. I know it looks kind of extra special, but it's just a letter O. So K, O, dotted, okay? So I'll show you. So basically, if I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna say, okay, so I'm just gonna do kind of the same plots I was doing earlier. So x is just going to go from 5 to 5, x squared. Okay, so I'm going to put it over here. Thank you, you're mad at all kinds of things, that's okay. I'll put this in a comment so it stops yelling at me. To make everything automatically a comment, you can control R. You can also right click and say comment, but then that'll get all the angry Matlab people away from me. So see, I have a black dotted line with circles. It's not super exciting, but I mean, I guess it's slightly better than what we had before, because right, what we had before was this, right? Actually, that was kind of prettier. I think I just don't like the black line as much. We can make it blue, so the K turns into a B. Now, it doesn't matter if I put the B at the beginning, or if I put the B in the middle, or if I put the X, this thingy there, like the order doesn't matter is what I'm saying. So you don't have to worry about, this is one of the very, very, very rare things in programming where apparently it's not gonna be an obnoxious twerp about it. And this almost never happens. So you should super duper duper enjoy it. And obviously, but yeah, hold on, before I say that, you can change things like if you wanted a dashed line, that would be like the double dash. If you wanted it to be a dash, what is dash dot? I forgot already. Dash dot. Oh, it's the dash. Literally a dash and a dot. Oops. So it's a dash dot, dash dot, dash dot. Instead of circles, I want it to be stars. Oops. Stars. Instead of blue, I want it to be magenta. And that's it. Okay, so what I was going to say is, now if you're using lin space, obviously, the more points you use, if you've got 10,000 stars, you can't really tell them apart anymore. So using markers really only works at some point when you've, you know, got, you know, only a certain number of data points, an effectively finite number of data points. Once you get to have too many data points, then it's like, oh, why am I showing all these markers? Because, like I said, it just gets to be like that. And you're like, well, I just got a fat line now. And that's okay. Everybody loves it. Everybody loves a chubby magenta line. I'm not sure if that has some kind of double meaning of some kind of drug use, so I'm just going to say that. We like lots of extra marker size. I should stop while I'm ahead. Anyway, we're having fun with our marker sizes, and it's great. Or markers in general, it's great. We're going to have fun with marker sizes in a minute. If you think this has been fun, you wait till we get to marker sizes. Okay, so let's do this. So actually, we can do things like this. Really, where this becomes useful is if we're doing stuff like different lines for more than one plot, I guess, at a time. So let's say that we're going to do 0 to 2 pi, and we're going to do sine, 2 sine, 3 sine, 4 sine. And in this case, you're going to want to have, you know, maybe more control over what those look like. So, you know, if you kind of feel like you know what's going on, I'd say pause the video and try to play. Otherwise, we can play together. But, you know, ideally, CLC clear. So I'm going to have X go from 0 to 2 pi and put, you know, a whole bunch in there. I'll do y1. And since I'm doing 2 pi's, I'm doing radians, so I'm using the regular sine function. y2. Getting all these like tool tips, and I feel like it's blocking what y'all can see. Maybe one day I'll figure out how to turn off tool tips. Okay, so let's plot x, y1, and now it's giving us this option for line style, marker, and color. So that's what we were just doing. So you can kind of go back up and decide what you want to do. Blue, green, red, cyan, magenta, yellow, black, white. White probably doesn't make any sense. Diamond, up and down triangles, hexagram, pentagram, solid, dash, dot, dash, dash, dash. So whatever kind of makes you happy. So blue, da-da, and da-da. And now remember, if I try to go in here and say magenta, and dash, dot, I'm only going to see the second one. Well, first of all, I've got way too many points to be showing marker sizes, or to be showing markers. But I'm only seeing the second one because I forgot to. If you said, hold on, you get a cookie. Yeah, hold on. And I'll hold off down here. So plot x, y, 3, and I can just pick k, circle. I don't know. Regular line? Sure. And then plot x, y, 4. What have I not used? Green. Hexagram? What was a hexagram? H and double dashed? Yeah, I think I didn't use double dashed. Green, hexagon, double dashed? Look how exciting that is. Isn't this just like the best thing you've ever done? Oh, and I can also say, oh, looky, my axes is off. And this happens in MATLAB a lot, where instead of going from 0 to 2 pi, it just rounds up to 7. So I can be like, I know how to do this. I can change the axis with parentheses because it's a function, and a bracket inside because it's a da-da-da-da-da matrix, and it goes x limit, x low, x high, y low, y high. So x low, 0 to 2 pi, and it looks like it's going from negative 4 to 4. And now it's beautiful. Oh, and I can add a legend. Look how cool I am. I'm basically like the most awesome plot maker in all of the whole world. So that's why I'm cool. Now, they're always going to be in order. There's ways to get around it, but it's like advanced plot making of who cares. But see, now whenever you have your little legend, look how pretty that is. It's so cool. I love it. It's got its little thingies there. And I can make a title. I am amazing. And then I can do an X label that says, you're not as cool as me. except now it's yelling at me because I didn't put an extra quote there. And then I can say Y label, but you could be one day. Ah! Isn't that fantastic? Don't you love it? You gotta love science. This is science. It's kind of like science. It's science adjacent. Plotting is like science. Anyway, I'm having fun. It's awesome. Okay, so just in case you don't have enough power and control over MATLAB yet with plots, there's like some legit dorkiness you can do if you really want to get into it. So you can actually get into the marker sizes, the styles, all that kind of stuff. So if you've got this already kind of ready to go, take all this, leave it how you have it up there, but bring it down here and copy paste. And I would say, so for these things, so you can kind of get this set up, but if you hit comma here, it's gonna have some like options. And you're like, huh, what are those? Oh, wow, you got all kinds of stuff. So actually, I can change the color to more than just those specific colors. I'll get to that. Line style, line width, marker, marker indices, and some other things. I don't know, but you know, I'm gonna go with line width because this is kind of hard for you to see because I'm zoomed out pretty far. But let's go with line width. And it just automatically, and it says default is 0.5. It needs to be a positive value. I'm gonna make it bigger than it is now, so let me just put in a 2. No idea what I'm doing. That's okay. We're just playing. I'm going to run it again, and I got a fatter line, and apparently fatter triangles, chubbier triangles. I'm going to undock this to see. Yeah, I clearly have chubbier triangles, and yeah, okay. That's something. All right, I like it. I'm down with the chubby triangles. Let me put it here so maybe it's a little bit better shape. And then I can do, no, I'm just making a mess. That's okay. Okay, so line width. Now if I hit comma again, I've got marker indices. I don't even know what that is. Indices of data points at which to display markers. Oh, so if I don't want to display them all, like right now I'm displaying 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So maybe if I only wanted to display like 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. I'm amazing. I can figure so many things out by guessing because MATLAB is so amazing and it's like way better than it was when I was in college. Woohoo! Look at this. Okay. So, and apparently I didn't need that, but you know, what do I know? I just literally figured this out like right now, but that was pretty fun. Okay. So I can do that. That's pretty amazing. I'm running out of space here, so let's see what else I can do. Comma. Options. Color. What other colors are there? Oh, I can do RGB triplets, hexadecimal codes. I can do that RG thingy. So now is where the fun part is. I can do like hexadecimal codes. Hexadecimal code for colors. So I can just like pick a color that I like. Clearly, I like, what do I like? I don't know. I don't like the green that it gave me. So I'm actually gonna do this on a, and get a better green. What's a better green? I like this green. I need a hexadecimal code. What's the hex code? I wonder if it's this one. Maybe it's this one. I don't know. I should know this. Color chart. Hex, hexadecimal. That's probably hexadecimal. I'm guessing that's hexadecimal because those are all like less than F. Let's see what happens. I'm completely making this up, but we're gonna see what happens if I do this. If I do color, I don't know. Well, now that one's gonna be green. No, okay, that was not what it wanted. Oh, okay, it says valid names include this. Valid hexadecimal consists of a pound followed by three or six digits. Gup-shoop. Oh my gosh, that's what it was. Okay, so what is that even doing? Oh, okay. So it's doing like a magenta line and then putting a green line on top of it. That's not even the green I wanted. Or maybe it was, I guess it's kind of the green I want. I want a darker green. Do this darker green. Okay. This is like the really important part of the class, you can see. So I'm going to take away, actually I'm going to do it on this one because this is the green I don't like. So I'm going to take away this green and make it this green instead. There we go. See? Did you see the difference between that green? So it used to be this, hold on. It used to be this green, like that. And I think that's kind of hard to see, so I changed it to this green. And I think that's better. I think it would also help if I made it a little bit thicker. So I'm gonna make the line width. I like thicker line width. Line width, I'm gonna make it also two, like that. Thicker lines. So basically you can also change marker size. Marker size. The default size is six, so I'm gonna obviously make it 12. Look, they're giant triangles. It's fantastic. Marker size. I can also probably change the marker color. Marker mode. What's marker mode? Auto manual. I don't want to play with that. That sounds scary. Marker face color and edge color. Oh, wow. Okay, I can change the edge color to black. And I'm going to change the marker face color. Marker face color to yellow. I think that's a thing. Holy potatoes. That's amazing. Okay, so like this should basically take up the rest of your day because, I mean, why would you not want to play with this for like ever now? So anyway, I promised fun with programming, and I guess in certain places in the world this might be considered super fun. I had a good time, so maybe you did too. But anyway, so the basics, I think, is just being able to use these kind of things, that MB dot blah blah blah. But if you really want to get stuff that like kind of pops, I think this is kind of like, you know, strutting your stuff at the MATLAB, I don't know, people who hang out and do MATLAB group of people. I should really plan my sentences before I start them. Anyway, I hope you had fun. See you in the next video.